Hi Queens, it's Vivi and welcome to the Board Game Stamina event featuring these two beautiful fray suits. So I'm so excited to show you this event because it is the funnest event I have done in a while. It makes me so excited to log in every day to play. Now for those who have never done this board game before, it may be a lot, there are a ton of rules, but I'm here to share with you pro tips and strategies I used to finish both of these suits in just around 1,000 stamina. That's right, I only use about 200 stamina per day. The event is only halfway through and I'm already about finished. So the point of this event is to feed this cat in the center. This cat requires a lot of berries, which brings me to pro tip number one, land on berries on the map. So let me show you an example of a berry. Oh gosh, I already ate all the berries. Here's an example of a tile that gives a bunch of berries, but the berries would look like this on the tile. It's like two red strawberries clumped together. Like the strawberry would be here, but then I ate it already. So yeah, that's why it's empty. Feed the cat 45 berries and you get one random item of either set's non-repeating, but don't worry, getting berries are so easy. Each time you roll the dice for 5 stamina, you get one berry, but there are a ton of ways to increase your berry count and I'll show you how. But first, do your daily free attempt. So to do your daily, you just click on this exclamation mark here, which is the present box, and I get 5 free attempts today. So boom, there you go. And here are the past free attempts. Like, as you see, some days give free attempts. Oh no, I didn't even log in these 2 days to collect my free attempts. But yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've logged in only 5 days and I'm about done. And yeah, there's still a lot more days of free attempt. Anyway, let me just play this and show you how it goes. So here's the roll the dice button at the bottom. I'm just going to roll it. I want a big roll. 3. That sucks. Okay, so I pass things this guy. When I pass this guy, it's going to be a battle stage, but since I already completed a battle stage, I'm just going to click this go away button and it's going to give me 2 berries. It's terrible to land on this thing because even if you pass it, you're gonna get those 2 berries anyway. So yeah, I got those coins. Those coins that I just landed on, it's to buy these items right here, but I'm not too worried about the items. I'm looking for a big roll so that I could get to the end and I get good stuff when I get to the end. Dang it, 3! Yeah, as you can see, I got a berry for rolling that 3. Alright, now it's a mini game. What is this item here? Oh no, I can't read Chinese. It's just big. I got it wrong and I got 3 coins. Get it that wrong. If I got it right, I would have gotten 5 coins, but not worried at all about the coins. All I care about are berries! Berries! Okay, so I've reached the end. Now I'm back at the start. Each time you reach the start, you get to choose a buff right here. Now let me translate to you what these buffs do. This first run right here is every 3 items used, you get 1 free berry. That's nice, but I'm not guaranteed to use a lot of items, so I skip this. And then this one is for every 5 coins gained, I get 1 berry. I don't really care about getting coins, so I skip this too. My goal is to speed run through the map, like roll a ton of 6s and stuff. That's why I think this is the most important. This translates to pass the finish line and get 3 free berries, and this is usually the buff that I choose. I always choose the 3 berry buff, so I'm gonna go for that. Now let's speed run towards the end. Now what do I want to land on here? Don't care about anything here. Maybe this envelope, because this envelope has a chance to get berries, but I want to land on this 3 berry thing right here. I am going to use some buffs. Let me explain what these tickets do. Number one, this dice, choose your roll. Very, very important. If you use it, you choose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and you're gonna land on that spot. Next one, guaranteed to roll the number 1. I mean, it could be useful, but not too important. This one refreshes the shop, completely useless. I never use this. This one is use your Momo companion and have it go 6 paces back to grab the item. Okay-ish important, I guess. This one's open shop, useless. I never use it. And this one, double roll. This one is super important. So this dice and this double roll, I think, are high tier. This one is mid tier. Everything else, bleh, completely useless. I have that written on the right of my screen. Dice, a dark blue ticket, and gold ticket, most important. All right, now let's do a big daddy roll. Let's just try the double roll thing, which leads me to my last pro tip. big rows equals cost less stamina, I guess. Yeah, I'm trying to speed run through the sport, so I don't need to spend a lot of stamina. So let's use this double row. I'm gonna show you how to get those tickets later too. So all right, let's do the double row and five. That sucks. So whenever you pass the shop, you can buy the stuff right here. You can see that some of them have hefty discounts. This is a 50% off for the dice. This is worth it. So I would totally buy this, but you know, I'm low on coins right now. I don't really care about getting coins, but it's okay. I've already collected so many of these dice, so meh, don't matter. I'm just gonna bounce from here. All right. Yeah, that was a poo-poo row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I want to row a 5 so that I could get to the berry. So let's do this dice right here. Select the 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, look here. So I reached 45 berries and I get one random item from either of the suits, and I got this one right here, 9 out of 10. Sweet. Oh, I actually already finished this suit. This flower suit, I'm already done with. I'm just working on the final piece of this dark suit now. All right, let us continue with the board game. Let us roll. I want Big Daddy rolls. Where do I want to land? Don't care about any of these. Where's the next thing I care about? Maybe this envelope. Berry, there's a berry. Oh yeah, let's head towards that berry then. I'm gonna use my pack, I'm gonna use the buff, I'm gonna use the double roll. Let's do that. And for the double roll, I got, oh, 9. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so I passed this thing. Go away, give me my 2 berries. Nice. And oh, that's where I land on. I got nothing. Oh, I sort of want to land on this envelope. You know what? I'm just going to land on it for educational purposes. To land on the envelope, it's only one pace in front of me, right? So I'm going to use this turtle thing. This guarantees my next row to be 1, so I'm going to use it. And I'm going to press this dice, and then it's going to be 1. And okay, so hello, Kimmy. So I get to open an envelope here, and the envelope is going to give me a gift, and the gift is going to be berries. Thank you. So I can also get coins from there, but berries are most important. Now, oh, I actually want to show you this thing. This thing's pretty important too. Let me just land on that for educational purposes. So I'm going to choose my row, and I'm going to row 2. And it tells me that my companion partner Momo is going to go down this road, and me, the Nikki, is going to go down this road. So because me and my Momo are splitting up, we get 2 times the rewards. So let's say we roll like a 2, and then Momo's gonna land on here, and I'm gonna land on here. So we reap the benefits of both sides. If I did not land on this square, then me and Momo would just go down this path together, and this path would just, no one would walk on it. Okay, now let's roll. I want to land on this berry. That's all I care about. I don't care about anything else. So I want to roll 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, let's just do this roll, and I rolled a 5. Okay, that's stupid. Okay, so Momo was walking, got a coin, and I got this dude. Yeah, go away, give me my berries. And now the berry is just 1 step ahead, so I'm gonna use the turtle yet again, and I'm gonna roll. And what do I get? 1, of course. And yeah, oh, I want to show you another thing too. This thing is pretty cool too. I can use this to send my Momo backwards to grab some items. So let's just use this for educational purposes. This dark blue ticket, go away, Momo. Okay, so yeah, he grabbed 2 coins for me. Yay, 2 coins. Not that I need those 2 coins. Okay, let's continue. Now the next important thing, I guess, would be this thing. Yeah, let me just show you this thingy for educational purposes. I want to roll 3. 1, 2, 3. Yep. So let's choose my roll. 3, and 1, 2, 3, and it's going to bring me to the spinning wheel thing. This thing is pretty important because you can get berries and gold coins, and you can get items from here too. So now, what is this item here? I don't know, I can't read Chinese, it's a lamp. Oh, and I got it right, and I got 5 for getting it right. Yay! What else is there? Let me just roll for funsies, I guess. 5, I land on a 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I get a 1 free item here, I guess. Let's just keep rolling. I got a 2, that is so trash. But I got that ticket right there. there. Let's keep rolling yet again. One! Ew! Ew! That's so bad. Okay, so I land on that shop and I get an opportunity to buy the stuff here. Not interested in anything here. Again, pro tip on the right on my screen. The most important ones are the dice, the dark blue ticket, so this one, I guess, and the gold ticket, and I'm actually going to skip this, so yeah, I'm outie. Let us roll again, and I'm gonna reach it. I did not reach the end! Oh, well, at least that gave me a free attempt, I guess. It says here a free attempt, one time, and you see I have 12 stamina here, right? So I'm gonna roll this, and yeah, it did not take away my stamina. At least I reached the end, and I got the 3 bonus for reaching the end, and now I'm starting over at the very beginning, and I'm gonna pick the same buff, which is the one that guarantees 3 berries at the end. Alrighty, what do I want to do now? What do I care about? Or what do I want to show you? Which have I not shown you yet? Oh, I haven't shown you this yet. Let's do a big fatty double roll so that I can reach that to show you. Let me roll that, and I got 8. Let's see where this brings me. 6, 5, 4. It brings me to a shop. Don't care about anything here. I already have a lot of items already. Yeah, go away. Click the go away button and it'll give you 2 berries. And 1. Oh, I landed on a present. This is so good. Okay, so you want to roll a 6. If you roll a 6, you get everything here. If you roll a 1, you only get this one item here. Alright, Momo bless me. I got a 6! Yeah, this is how I got so many items because I land on that president so much. And look at all these items. Oh, so good, so good. Alrighty. I also want to show you this thingy right here. That's like exchange items. Like if you have a lot of this item, for example, and this is such a poo-poo item, you can exchange it for something that's actually useful, like the dice. So I'm gonna use a 1 roll and let's land on that. Let me just show you for educational purposes. Okay, so what can I exchange here? I can exchange 2 of these blue tickets for 3 of these dice. The blue ticket is actually useful. For this one, I can exchange 3 of these dice for 3 of these shop tickets. Trash. This one, I never use these tickets, so this may be worth it. So let's do the exchange. Hello? Boom. There. 2 free dice for giving away 2 of these tickets. What's this? Give away 2 dice for these blue tickets. Useless. Give away 4 of these shop to get 3 of these turtles. I already have enough turtles. No, thank you. This one, I don't even have. Over here, it says I have 2 of these blue tickets, and they're asking for 3, so if I do this, it's not even gonna do that. So, alright, I am outing. So, yeah, that's the exchange thing. And what else do I want to show you? Let me show you this thing again, because this is spinning a wheel thing, and there are other things that you can land on. Okay, here is the one, and alright, let's spin the wheel. Show me the berries! Dang it! I got the mini game again. So this mini game, I guess the name of this item. It's obviously this flower one. I got that wrong. Whatever. Okay. Let's just continue then. Let me just do rolls without buffs so I show you the other tiles. Alright. So I land on that thing, get 2 free berries. Thank you. Here's the envelope. So here's Kimi again, and open the envelope. Get 3 goodies. Berries. Thank you. Thank you. And what else is important? Nothing. Nothing. Oh, berries. 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 Okay. You know what? Let's double roll it. Let's do a Big Daddy a double roll so I can reach this. Oh, wait, did I overkill that? Did I overkill? I did. It was, that's too much. That's 2, 6, 5, 4, 3. No! That's okay. Calm down. I overshot it, but because I have this a blue ticket, I can send my Momo back 1 phase to grab the berry. Oh yeah, that's how you get good at this game. And the next spot that I care about, I'm 41 out of 45 now. I will finish this in 1 more roll. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I need to roll a 6 to get to this 3 berry. So let's use this dice. Let's do this 6 roll. and yay, now we're traveling together, and this cat is 45 out of 45, you see that? And there is my final item. This coat is my final item. Oh my gosh, 10 out of 10. So completed. Let's check over here. Everything has been collected. If I keep playing, if I keep spending stamina, then I'll have the opportunity to get these stuff. All completely trash. I guess the Princess Reset card is the only one useful here. But yeah, that is all. You see that the cat bar went back to 0 out of 45. I'm donezo. I'm not gonna come back here again. I'm just gonna use free attempts going forward. But now it is time to collect my suits, and let me show you how they look like. So this dark suit, ooh, a special top pose, I think 25 diamonds back for troubles, and this flower one, ooh, arm pose, maybe glove pose. If it is, oh my gosh, I would love if it's a glove pose. 25 free diamonds back for my trolls. I spent 0 diamonds on it and it only costs 1,000 stamina. Dude, this event is so good and it is so fun. I'm actually sad that I finished it because now I don't get to play it anymore. I don't want to waste my stamina just to play this now because I'm not gonna get any suits anymore. Here is my view room, and it is going to be the two new suits over here and over here. Let me show you the flower one first. Alrighty. Hey cutie! First up, we had this flowy hair, and then we had this flowy dress. Here are the shoes, here's the ribbon, earrings, wristlet, bag, here's the butt item. And then here is the flower. And then the posed version looks like this. This is arm pose! Arm pose! Yes! This is a glove pose! Oh, this makes me so happy! I love these kind of poses because I can now mix and... Okay, that looks bad. Oh, that looks bad. I can now mix and match with different kinds of dresses, and it's going to look so good if it don't already have a hand. Like, this one, it looks amazing! Ah! Okay, so yeah, that is pretty much it for this one. There's no like special movable background pieces or anything. And then the dark suit looks like this. Suit breakdown time. Here's the hair. Here is a coat. Separate top, separate bottom. Here are the long socks. And then here are these, whoa, spooky looking boots. Here's the cap. Here's the earrings, and here is a, that's not a coat, I think that's a scarf or something, IDK. And then here is a microphone, and the pose version looks like this. This is a, is this a coat pose? I think this is, yeah, that is a coat pose. So yeah, that is it for these two suits. I love these so much, please come to Love Nikki.